Hey everybody, welcome back to Project Overflow. And just to let you know, we're still on some form of lockdown. And we're going to take a little bit of a shift in terms of the format we're doing. We're actually going to be answering questions more specifically. So the videos will be shorter and easier for you to look for the particular topic that you want to. So today we want to actually cover a topic, very interesting one, on credit card. So are credit cards good or bad? I think that's the question that I think a lot of people are asking. And looking at the economy now, how do we deal with our credit cards, Zuan?
Oh, okay. This question, I think for me, how would I approach this question is what is the purpose of a credit card, right? So credit card, good or bad? Yes, I've heard a lot of arguments and also a lot of debates. Should we have a credit card? Should we not have a credit card and all of that? So my take on it is pretty simple. If you are bad with money, you shouldn't get a credit card. Okay, if you can't even manage cash, you don't then don't get a credit card. But if you are already good in managing your money, okay, then if you are thinking of getting a credit card, I think the first question is to ask yourself, what is the purpose of getting a credit card? Okay, some people will say cashback, some people will say I'll get points and things like that. So if that is the case, you want to stretch more of your, get more mileage from your spending already, and you have that discipline of paying off and clearing the bills, then I think credit card shouldn't be a problem for you. So it's my take on it. It's just a tool. It doesn't have a nature, good or bad. It's all on how you as the user use it. So that is my point of view. So what about you, Eugene?
I think personally for me, coming from the banking industry before, I think credit cards are, again, they are neutral. They are a tool, right? Like what Zuan was saying. However, the tool comes with a lot of attraction. Okay, and that's where the danger is. Okay, for example, extended payment plan, are they good or bad, right? So they're not good or bad, but it actually allows you to spend future money today. So you may not have the money. If you already have the money and you're willing to buy the thing and you wanted to take the extended payment plan because it was cheaper, then maybe. Yeah, but if not, putting anything like that or taking the credit out of your card to spend it first, it's always the danger is this, right? That if you forget to pay it back, I think that is the, you know, or you miss 1 day or 2 days out of it. Okay, so it's got to do with repayment. So I think I subscribe to what you're saying as well, that if, you know, you can't manage your money well, you cannot manage your credit card. And credit card only explodes the problem that you may have, okay? Really make it very big. Okay, because now you're spending money that you're not making. That is the issue.
Yep.
Any other things in terms of your thoughts?
I think it's all about the wisdom. Fall into peer pressure. And I think also it says in the Bible, I can't remember exactly the words, everything is permissible, okay? But not everything is beneficial, right? So just reevaluate the reason why are you getting a credit card and really be truthful to yourself. If you're bad with money, don't get credit card because it's so easy, like what Eugene mentioned, it's so easy to use, to leverage on credit, right? Easy payment plan, you can even spend money that you don't already have. So what is the true reason of getting a credit card? Evaluate that and make a wise decision whether to have it or not. And also, for me, is I also know sometimes if you don't have a credit card, in our cases in Malaysia, you can't build a credit score. Then again, is that what you need currently? And all, really take time to think about it rather than just jumping into it.
Yeah, you know, and you know, just another trappings that they are out there is this, right? I know when I used to have, five credit cards at hand, and each credit card would give me anywhere between 20, 30, 50,000 ringgit worth of credit, right? So, and each bank will call and say, hey, would you like to convert your credit in your card into term loan? Okay, so it's so easy for that to happen. And especially if you're converting it because you're doing a business that will make you back money and more, then maybe that is fine. But if the purpose is to now fund your lifestyle, then I say that that is going to be very dangerous.
Yep.
So it really depends back on you yourself. Your how disciplined you are. Self-discipline is very important in how you manage your money. Okay, so that's for us. You know, I think we both think that it's neutral. But if you ask me, if you can do without one, do without one. Yeah. I live without a credit card for a long time now, and I'm still fine, right? And my credit score is okay. All right, so if there's any other questions, don't forget to ask your questions in the chat below, in the chat box below, or, with the link that we are sending this video out with, because if you want to stay anonymous, okay, but we will answer your questions. If you've got any other thoughts as well, share with us, how are you managing with your credit card? All right, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next episode. Bye.